Oh, this is probably going to be cringe. This is from AP. Small nuke reactors emerge as energy option, but risks loom.
Oh, my God.
And if they're talking about the Gen 3 SMR, yeah, they're talking about the SMRs. Those things are walk-away safe.
The only thing I know about Gen 3 are the Sinnoh region, Palkia, Dialga, Giratina, and Arceus. Sorry, Pokemon joke.
Yeah. Nuclear power also poses risks, including disposing of highly radioactive waste and keeping that technology out of the hands of rogue countries or nefarious groups that may pursue a nuclear weapons program. You can't do that with Gen 3 reactors, people! Especially SMRs. They're made specifically to avoid that.
Speaking of SMRs, I thought those
risks have been accentuated. You knew this was going to happen. Following the shelling around Europe's largest nuclear power plant in Ukraine, which has raised fears of potential nuclear disaster. Yeah, you knew that was gonna be. Even if a disaster doesn't happen, that's gonna be like a Fukushima thing.
Hi, everyone. Can you hear me? I thought I would try this to see if it might be relaxing.
That's ASMR.
Oh, right. I got it mixed up.
Small modular reactor as opposed to whatever the hell ASMR stands for.
Hey, at least you got the joke I was going for.
Yeah. I don't really have a good mic for that. You really need a good condenser that you can get up close to. And this is a nice dynamic mic. It's an electro voice. I love how it picks up my voice, but I love how if I want to talk low, I can get close to it. If I want to talk louder, I can move away from it, and it doesn't change the tone of my voice that much. Not like the condensers where the basses really get cranked up as you get close to it. The introduction of unproven nuclear technology in the form of SMRs doesn't sit well with environmentalists. Proliferation of small reactors will exacerbate the problem of how to dispose of highly radioactive nuclear waste. You burn it. That's what you do. You use it as fuel, you idiots. I just want to be like, you know, Ren and go, Steepy, you idiot, whack. The Rolls-Royce SMR would generate nuclear waste the size of a tennis court piled 1 meter high. Oh, my God. No, it wouldn't. Any country acquiring nuclear reactors automatically enhances its capacity to make nuclear weapons. Every SMR could produce around 10 bombs worth of plutonium each year. All they would have to do is tell the International Atomic Energy Agency to stop inspections, as Iran has done, for example. Oh, give it up on the Iran thing, people!
Hey, at least they haven't said the C word yet.
Yeah. And so you'd think nuclear weapons would have been a good anti-war deterrent. That's why they don't want them to. We want to be the only one with nukes. We want to be the only one with nukes. So we can threaten everyone else. But I mean, it's just like the U.S. and everyone else put sanctions on Russia so no one can trade with Russia. No one can trade with Russia. And Russia said, okay, we're not going to trade anyone. We're stopping exports. Oh, Russia is weaponizing the economy, I think is what they said. It's like, so when Russia does it with their own trade, they're weaponizing the economy, but everyone else does it with Russia. They're applying to third party countries, even they're applying sanctions.
Always double standards. Always effing double standards.
Yep. I mean, the Sahara wouldn't be a bad place for it, or, you know, any desert like that, because, you know, you get a lot of sunlight, but you also don't have to worry about, you know, snow and ice on the solar panel. And you also don't have to worry about, like, the land use stuff, which is really big with solar, if there's this vast, you know, areas of land that are unused.
By the way, does anyone know where I can get black market organs? Asking for a friend.
I don't know, I think there's some underground music stores, if you know where to look. See what I did there?
Damn it. You know, it reminds me of one time back when I used to go to church. There was this streaker, right?
Yeah.
And he was a slippery one, but eventually they caught him by the organ.
But people are seeing the problem with solar panels. I mean, just last year alone, Amazon finally reported that, you know, because they've been putting rooftop solar on, and it was like, I think in over a third of the places where they installed rooftop solar, the panel spontaneously combusted.
California's doing enough to share the problems with electric.
Yeah. Oh my god. They're telling people not to charge electric cars. That's crazy. The problem is just the limitations and the side effects of photovoltaics. If they were to set up something like solar salt, where instead of having solar voltaics, you have an array of mirrors concentrating it on a heating element and use the heating element to heat up molten salts. You know, they got a few of those in China. I think Spain has a couple. Remote solar has too much transition loss to be effective. Well, that's why you keep it as heat. Don't try to turn it into, electricity on site. Just turn it into heat. Grab the heat of the sun and then just pipe the heat off to wherever you want it and do whatever you want to with the heat. You can turn it into electricity or use it to, like, if you've got a factory that's, forging and it needs to, be able to melt iron, you just run the heat through that and use it to heat the forge or whatever.
This is starting to sound like a Sunny D commercial.
That's also a good thing to use for nuclear because nuclear reactors don't produce electricity. They produce heat, and you have to turn the heat into electricity. But nuclear reactors are constant. It's like the exact opposite problem with solar. The sun doesn't shine at night, and it can get cloudy, and, you can have snow on your solar panels and all sorts of stuff. So it just goes up and down all over the place. Nuclear is the opposite. It's constant, but people don't use electricity constantly. They're using a lot in the day, and then they turn off everything at night, and the usage goes down and stuff like that. So for either technology, or even both of them combined together, a molten salt loop is a great way to deal with that. Because you just use the molten salt to store the heat and then draw the heat off as you need it. I mean, everyone's going crazy about proliferation, but think about how important, especially this year, we're seeing how important energy is and energy independence and things like that. And if you've got a country that's thinking, okay, we can have nukes that will just piss everyone off and we probably won't even use, and if we did, it would be really bad, and it whatever, advantages we have will be outweighed by a lot of disadvantages and whatever. Or we could use nuclear power, instead of making it into weapons, make it into reactors and just use that and get all of the benefits from the energy and not having to deal, with other countries with, the crap they're doing about energy. That's got to be more attractive even for a government. And that's exactly Iran's position. They're like, nuclear weapons won't do us any good. We want nuclear power. And yes, Iran did let in the weapons inspectors and the weapons, they don't have a weapons program. But you got to have someone to fearmonger about. Because if you're a government, what else are you going to do? Because everything you do sucks and fails and is terrible. You got to have someone to blame.